name is Alex Karekas, and I want to welcome you to the Finding Lost Civilization series. Now, this series is dedicated to visiting ancient sites that time has long forgotten. Our journey today is going to be fascinating because we're visiting an area called the Carrizo Plains, which are located in San Luis Obispo County in California. Well, the fascinating thing about this area is the drawings, the pictographs left behind by the natives that once roamed this region. We know that the Chumash, the Yokuts, and the Salinan tribes visited this area and left behind evidence of past life. However, the most exciting thing about our trek today is when we leave the Carrizo Plains and encounter a baby elk that had been abandoned by its herd and our efforts to save it. Well, I know today is going to be an exciting journey, and I invite you to trek with me to the Carrizo Plains. You are seeing exactly what I'm seeing. We're entering this, I guess, sandstone outcrop here, which has these naturally formed caves from erosion. So let's go inside of this one. Oh, look at this, my friends, right up there. Man, that is a large nest. That is a big bird nesting up there. Can you see it? Well, anyways, here's what we have to do. We have to climb up over here, and I've got a walking stick. So as I said, you're seeing exactly what I'm seeing, and right now it's the ground. Okay, we're entered. Oh my goodness, look at this. This is really beautiful. My goodness, this is wonderful. Right over here, do you see this pictograph? My goodness, this is really a joy to behold. From this shelter over here, from this overhang, we're going to take a look. We're going to pan out to this great sandstone boulder. But right there at the very, very top, right over there, I'm going to try to zoom the camera in. There are some more pictographs. Here we go. Can you see them? Right there? Just barely? Well, we're going to take a climb. We're going to go around to see if we can come in closer to show you what they look like. This is a very interesting sandstone outcrop. Look at these configurations here, these little caves. What we're going to do, you and I are going to go in here together, okay? This is my first time in here. I've not been in here before. And I hope there's no snakes in here. But let me go in there. Okay. Well, look at this. You can tell there's coyote, evidence of coyote being here. Let's look up. I want to make sure that we don't get attacked by a mountain lion or a coyote or a snake. But look at this over here, my friends. Look at the ceiling. This here is smoke blackened. So you know the ancients came in here away from the elements and they cooked their food over here. Look at this. This is a smoke blackened ceiling. Well, anyways, let's move further into the cave. This is a very good shelter. And okay, I can stand up in here. And look at this, you can tell birds were here. There's evidence that birds were in here. And of course, other signs of animal life. Well, this is really interesting, my friends. Look at over here as we look at the blackened ceiling over here. It's quite dark. But right over there, follow the camera, right there. Do you see where my finger is pointing to? That's known as a reverse pictograph. And what I mean by reverse pictograph is what they have done is taken a natural element, this soot right over here, and with a stone, scraped away the soot back to the sandstone and made an image. And we have one right over here. And then right next to it, there's another image right over here, if you can barely make it out. So I see two images. Now the fantastic thing about this shelter is right over here to my left, there's this beautiful opening. A window through the Carrizo Plains. I'll tell you, this is really fantastic. friends. We have some mortars before us right over here. So the ancients definitely gathered food items at this spot, and left behind their symbols for us to find. Friends, this is really fantastic. Look at this over here. Mortars, blackened ceilings from fires. This is fantastic. My goodness, look at this here. Additional mortars right here. Right here, look at this. There's over a dozen of them right here at this spot. Oh my goodness, look at this right over here. This is really incredible. This is fantastic. This is beautiful. Let's continue our journey. Let's go to that sandstone outcrop where I saw the symbols from afar. And there they are directly in front of us. My goodness, this is really fascinating. These are beautiful. Well, before us, I see another overhang, so to speak. We're going to go inside and see if we can find any signs of life. So let's go forward over here. Again, we're together on this journey. I'll tell you, this is a lot of fun, and I hope you're enjoying yourself as much as I am. Look at the scenery out there. Well, anyways, you're going to hear me huff and puff as we climb this together. Look at this. We're going to continue over here. Looks like there's three levels, but my goodness, right there, this is going to be fantastic. I can see a wall full of symbols. Well, I'm excited. Let's take a trip up there. Well, look at this. I didn't even notice this. My goodness, it almost looks like an insect. Look at this over here. This looks like some kind of insect. Here are the wings. There's the two eyes, and there's the body right there. And below it, there's another symbol. I'll tell you, this is really beautiful. Well, let's continue climbing forward. You have to be careful. Look at down there below us. One wrong mistake, and I'll join those bleach bones down below us. But anyways, let's continue climbing. Here we go. I'm using one hand, but there you go. We have reached this wonderful spot right over here. I tell you, it's well worth the climb. Well, this is spectacular. Look at this. I tell you, not many people have seen this symbol up close, personal, in life, so to speak. This is a vast, desolate area. And these nooks and crannies are hidden. So you really have to know where to go. And oftentimes it's by luck. Scrambling amongst these boulders, these hills, you'll walk upon an ancient site and marvel at its wonder. Let me share an interesting facet of this pictograph. It's very beautiful. Let's call it a mandala, so to speak. But one of the interesting aspects of this pictograph is right over here where you see these white paint here. They're like little white dots. Can you see them? I'll come up close. There it is. They're little white dots outlining this symbol over here. Now, some people believe that these white dots right over here, here's a good representation, are put here by the shaman as a result of his psychedelic experience, so to speak, from using the datura plant. Some of the effects, apparently, while you're under the power of the datura plant, is to see these flashes of light, like stars. And so this is a representation of what he saw under his trance, under his shamanic voyage, his hallucinogenic trip, or whatever you might want to call it, his vision quest, some people might say. But this here is believed to represent what he sees under the influence of the datura plant or any other type of psychotropic that the shaman may have taken during his journey. Directly ahead of us, I see a tree, an old tree that's blocking an entrance to this little, I guess, shelter or canyon-like area. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through this bramble of bushes and see what we can find inside. Let's go over here. I can see a small little pathway right through here. So this is exciting. I haven't been in here yet. This is the first time that I'm in here. We're going in together. Look at this. This is fabulous. It's a shelter, without a doubt. And look at this over here. You can tell that there's something here. What is it? Look at this over here. Can you imagine standing here and getting a view of the valley below? Let's take a look. My goodness, that's beautiful. And I can't believe this. Look at this. We're standing here. This is a milling station. So the families got together in the hot sun and processed their foods here in the shade underneath this overhang. I tell you, this is wonderful. You know, the mortars over here are a little different than you would find in central or northern California, where they have the acorn. You see, with the acorn, you had the nut or the shell to break open. And so a lot of times there was what we call an anvil. Right over here there would be a depression where the nut would be broken. And then it would be placed inside the mortar and then crushed. But in this area, in the Carrizo Plain, they processed the grasslands. So they were able to take the seeds from the grasses, directly put them in here, into the mortar, and grind them, pound them, and develop foods from them, without needing this anvil piece right over here, like they would break open an acorn. So this is really fascinating. Here's another one right over here. My goodness, this is, oh, look at this. Oh my goodness. Look at this, friends. This is beautiful. My goodness. This is really fantastic. And look at this. Again, there was something over here. Much of it is gone, but still it's beautiful. Look at this. My goodness. You can see, and there, look, right over there is another one. Let's take a look at it. It's a circular pattern. Friends, if you look at this, the sandstone, you see how it's sloughing away? And again, as I said, maybe 100 years from now, these will not be here due to natural erosion. I tell you, we are so fortunate to be able to be here and see these images that are going to be lost in time. Oh my goodness, look at that. I didn't even notice that before. And right over here, look at this. And that over there. My goodness, this is a fantastic spot. But look, again, over there, there's further symbols up there. This is incredible. This is really a beautiful spot. Let me show you something interesting. I was sitting here in a shade adjacent to these mortars, and I looked up to the wall right over here where the symbols are directly in front of us. You can see over here some of the red paint. And I looked down over here after looking at the rest of the wall and noticed these circular patterns over here. There's one here, there's one here, there's one here, there's one here, and another one here, and one more over here. Now, I looked at the rest of the wall. These are the only type symbols or patterns like this directly in front of us. And then I looked up over here and I noticed another, what I'll call a symbol. And I took a look at it. And you see over here, right over here, there's red paint radiating out of here. My friends, I believe these right over here are what we call cupules. Now, cupules are sometimes related to fertility symbols. But this symbol right here, if I'm looking at it directly, it's what I call a yoni symbol. It's another type of fertility symbol. And you can see right here, right from the center, red paint radiating out here. I can see it with the naked eye. I don't know if you'll be able to see it with the camera. But I believe these are cupules, and this is what's called a yoni symbol. In other words, this is a representation of the vulva. Our journey together in the Carrizo Plains has been really fantastic. But I'll tell you what, in this next segment, I'm going to show you a scene that gave me the most joy, the most pleasure of our trek here into the Carrizo Plains. While driving down this highway here in the Carrizo Plains, we came upon this baby elk laying here in the middle of the road. It doesn't appear that it's been hit by a car, maybe abandoned by its parents. Look at it, very weak. What we're trying to do is give it some water and cool it down and hopefully move it off the side of the road, and perhaps it might survive. We hate to leave it just here because sure, as the sun sets, it will get run over laying here. Friends, what we have here in the middle of the road is a baby elk. And I tell you, it's a sad case because it's dehydrated. We've been watering it down to try to save it, but we can't leave it here in the middle of the road. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this towel and wrap it around the elk and then move it off to the side. And hopefully that will give it a fighting chance. Anyways, hopefully what we're doing will work. Well, we've moved the baby elk off the roadway. And what we did is we placed it right up there where you see that purple towel. And what we're going to do is we're going to wet the purple towel down. And hopefully that will give it some form of a hydration because it's blazing hot out here. Well, hopefully we can cheat nature today and this will help the little tyke here. He doesn't seem to be breathing as hard as before.
Much better.
Much better. Can you feel his tongue?
Yeah.
Tuckered out now. This is amazing. Dave placed his hands. He cupped it under the tyke's chin and placed some water in there. And I think the little elk felt somewhat connected in that feel, that touch of the hand to his mother, and he started drinking. And his breathing got a little better. My goodness. It just goes to show that a little bit of kindness or tenderness in any life form is always appreciated. Thank you.